Hey, what's up, everyone? And once again, welcome back to Super Sick Brothers for Wii U. Yes, I am still indeed sick. Last time, we played through Classic Mode using Zelda, got to Master Core, died in Master Core, and then finished it on 7.5. And this time, we're gonna head in as Sheik and hopefully see Master Fortress one more time. I think I just said Master Core twice as opposed to saying Fortress. You knew what I meant. Let's go. Cut your boy some slack. He's got a stuffed up nose and a stuffed up brain. I'm actually gonna leave Robin. He scares me a little bit, but I kinda wanna just go 1v1 this villager right now. Just to kinda get the gist of Sheik, because I actually used to main Sheik way back in the day. And by that I mean like a few years ago, because this game is only 4 years old. I say only! This game is 4 years old. That is bonkers to me. It does not feel like it was 2014 when this came out. I had just moved to the US when this game came out. Correction, I just moved to the US and then this game came out like 2 months after that. That is crazy. Because I moved in September 2014, 3DS came out October. So I got that like a month after I moved, and then this one came out 2 months after that. It is wild. I remember doing a live stream day one. I think the first fight I did in the game was a Mario versus Bowser, because of course I played as Mario, because main. But yeah, I remember it. It's wild. It's so wild that this game is, at this point, basically past its life cycle. Like, this game's dying. It's going to be dead soon. No one's going to be playing Smash 4 once Ultima comes out. Hello, Meta Knights. Are you metal? Yes, you are. Also, I just got a Discord notification. You guys couldn't hear that, but it scared the crap out of me because it came through on my headphones. Ah. Alright, a little nervous about Metal Meta Knight here, because Sheik really doesn't have that much launching power, except on the down special, which is Bouncing Fish. So we'll see how we do. It might just come down to luck of the items. With any luck, we get something decent, or actually the stage could do him in, because like in a little transition area like that, for example, Meta Knight could, in theory, just kind of fall, because he's made of metal. He's fine. Oh, he's not fine! Never mind! I thought the stage was coming back up, but I guess not. He's just gone. He's just straight up gone. Rest in peace, Metal Meta Knight. Alright, this fight looks a little terrifying. Is it going to be a team fight? 2v2v2? No, it's just a 5-player free-for-all. With rival Robin. Okay. This feels like it would have been perfect for a team fight. You know, Bowser and Donkey Kong on a team, Marth and Robin on a team. And then we could have brought in, like, Villager or something. That's fitting with Sheik, right? I don't even know who else we had on the squad. Who else did we fight? Ooh, give me that. That's like a go-to Sheik combo right there, I think. I don't know, I don't actually play competitive, but I know that Bouncing Fish is one of Sheik's only killing moves, so... You know. Or the... Is it the forward? Oh god, the forward aerial? I don't know. I've honestly forgotten who else we fought, by the way. Like, that second match has gone out of my mind. Meta Knight! Metal Meta Knight! Unfortunately, he won't show up as metal. Okay, I just hit B, and she did a down aerial. That's not how that works, Sheik. It's not how that works. But apparently for Sheik it is. Alright. I'm just trying to burst grenade, but I don't want to do it over the freaking... That's an option? You know what? I'm fine with that outcome. Come here, Bowser. You don't scare me that much. Good freaking bye. We're keeping up with the tornado. Okay, then. I forgot what I was saying. That's a lot of stuff. Okay. Now, if we add the Meta Knight to the squad, to a team fight, I don't believe that he would actually be metal. So, you know. Are we getting Bowser? Oh! Apparently we caused that explosion. Because we got those trophies, meaning we got those KOs. Okay, then. I'm not complaining. Maybe my burst grenade actually did go off as I intended. Luigi. This stage, Mario Circuit Brawl, is actually coming back in Ultimate, and I believe they've just renamed it to, like, Figure 8 Circuit, which makes sense, because it's... Well, it's not quite the Figure 8 Circuit, but it's basically the Figure 8 Circuit. I mean, look at the map in the background. It's not quite a Figure 8. Also, I love that it's playing the Double Dash Rainbow Road music. This is a throwback, because I love me some Double Dash. Alright, special moves real quick. We have Needlestorm. You go ahead and charge it up like so. You can also shield out of it. I believe that Shy Guy is very much dead. And then you hit B again. You shoot out some needles that you can hardly even see. But they are... Wait. They... Wait. They are... Actually... Where are they? I swear that they actually exist. Okay, I definitely just threw needles. Okay, there you go. You can see them. They're really tiny. And you can, like I said, roll out of it, charge it up. If you do it in the air, they go down at an angle. The side special is the burst grenade that I've been trying to do this whole time. The longer you hold it, the further it goes, I believe, and it puts you into free fall after you use it, so don't do it above a pit. It's not great. I honestly don't find much use for that special move. The one I get the most use out of is the down B, bouncing fish, which you can kind of control how far it goes by how far you push the control stick. See, I didn't mean to do that. And you can also, like, really hold back on the control stick to barely go anywhere. You can also control when she does the little flip, the actual kick, as well. So, it's really good. It's got pretty high, knockback, because it's like her only killing move, to be honest with you. Kukos are gonna do some damage to Luigi right now while I explain the up B, vanish. It's basically just like Zelda's, except it's got an explosion as opposed to a little twirly move. And the Kukos took out Luigi for us. Okay, then. Not gonna complain about that. Here we go. Round 4 clear, 7 minutes in. Not doing too bad. I'm a little nervous about this last fight though, because it's probably a free-for-all and not a team fight in any way. Yup. It is indeed a free-for-all. At least our rival's out. We don't have to deal with him. Well, we wouldn't have had to deal with him at this stage anyway, because you knock him out in round 3 no matter what. So. Yeah. Let's see how we do. Mushroom Kingdom U! Let's go! Ground theme slash underground theme. All right then. Oh, you play that funky music. Go on, play it. Is there a more iconic video game theme song? I don't think there is. This is video game music at its finest. Just this tune in general. Not necessarily this rendition of it, but... Just this tune. Everybody knows this. Mario's out. All right. Okay. Big jigs. It's not what I wanted. Well, at least Kirby's out too. It's just Jigglypuff. Although, you know, Jigglypuff is a confident one for some reason. Right now. Come here. I'm not about to lose to you, Jigglypuff. You can take a stock. Okay. Bye. That works. You don't even get to take a stock. We're actually doing decent. Can you tell that I used to main Sheik? I might go back to using Sheik a bit more. Then again, that was all because of the Beetle just then. We didn't actually really do that ourselves, like, as Sheik. That was luck of the items once again. Which we may have to rely on here, depending on the effectiveness of Vanish. So we'll see. Because Feroar's Wind worked really good against the Miis, but I don't quite know how Vanish is gonna go. Yeah, it doesn't have quite as much launching power, so let's try Bouncing Fish. That also doesn't. Oh, we are going to die. Okay, at least we didn't. That's usually a good thing. We gotta just find the one move that works. Almost every character just has the one move that works really well in team fights. And ours might be Fire Bar. It might be the Fire Bar. I think it's the Fire Bar. The thing about the Fire Bar, though, is the more you hit with it, the... shorter it gets, as I'm sure you've noticed, and then the less damage it does, but it's still doing a decent chunk of damage, I would say. Billy, do you mind? Could you let me get back on the stage, Billy? Thank you. Break open the crate. Ooh, 3 bombs! I figured that was gonna happen. You know what? That's what you get. It didn't really do anything. Okay, never mind. Yes, it did. I don't want that boomerang. Like, I really don't want that boomerang. Burst grenade doesn't really work either. I'm gonna try and grab bomb shoot. Throw him. There we go. Okay, I picked up the boomerang. Just drop it because, God, that is a pain of an item. It just keeps coming back no matter how many times you throw it. Unless you pick up another item or somehow avoid it, it's gonna keep doing it. Alright, I'm hoping that the bomb can take someone down. Alright. Oh, that works. Goodbye. Me? Is that me? I think that's me. That's me. Oh, it's not me. That's Tammy. That is Tammy. Okay. So it's not quite me. It's basically me, but it's not quite me. I think I received that me from Augusto, because of course I did. He also gifted me Eric. Many different variations of Eric. Alright, here we go. The Master Core fight. As Sheik on 8.0, meaning we have a chance to get to Master Fortress. We also have a chance to defeat Master Fortress, but no promises. Did we actually finish it on 9 with anybody yet? I feel like we did. Was it like... was it Yoshi and Mario? I think we did it on 9.0 with... if not, we've at least finished Master Fortress with them. I'm not entirely sure. I don't know. It's been a few days since I did those runs, and I legitimately don't remember. Oh, another thing about Bouncing Fish, as you saw right there. If you land a hit with it, you can then land a second hit with it. And also more hits. Okay. Wow. I think I dropped a burst grenade by accident. And that actually, like, did a bit of damage to him. And that's what got the KO right there. Not complaining. Not complaining at all. Here's another burst grenade. Yeah, okay. Sure. Why not? It's not like our smashes are the most effective moves in the world. And Bouncing Fish can only do so much. Well, maybe. Maybe Bouncing Fish could come in handy here. Go ahead, drop that. I'm gonna go right... okay, I didn't mean to go over there. I didn't mean to go up there. Nope. Up smash for you. I'm sorry, I keep sniffling, like, involuntarily. And I'm gonna have to cut those out if I remember to. Well, I don't think I even can cut them out, because they're happening, like, as I'm speaking. So, I apologize right now if you hear a bunch of little... that I can't, help it. Those ones I could have helped, but that was intentional. Anyway. Shout out to flu season, folks! Shout out to flu season. Oh god. I'm not doing too great here. Could definitely be doing better for Master Beast. 94? Eh. I've just been trying to do the Bouncing Fish over and over again. Update. That is a meteor smash if he lands on you. Okay. Well. That has been noted. And there we go. I'm a little sad that we're going into edges with one stock. I would have liked to have been on two stocks here, but we'll just have to make it work. Just narrowly avoided that, holy crap. No. Oh, I didn't run in time. Did not run in time right there. So we can avoid that quite easy. Like so, down aerial past you. No, please, Master Edges. Please. I'm scared of Master Shadow. I want you to die soon. 3, 4. There we go. Finally getting the rhythm down on that move right there. Please no. Okay, that's the big ones. We can avoid those. Air dodge through that. And big ones again. No, no, no. Come on. You've got to be close to death, right? There we go. One more back air. 43 going into Master Shadow. One stock. Little nervous, because we're only going to get that one heart container. So, you know, little that scares me a little bit. But I'm also a little more confident with Sheik than... well, definitely a little more confident with Sheik than I was with Zelda, but we managed to get decently far with Zelda, I would say. Well, we didn't make it into the second phase with Zelda, but we got hit by a stupid laser. I'm talking more like movement-wise, I'm a little more confident with Sheik. As I'm sure you can tell. Because I'm actually moving... quite a bit with Sheik, because Sheik's a good character for movement, and a neutral aerial took him down. Okay. We got a chance here. There's obviously a chance that we could also die. I'm gonna leave that. Okay, fine. We'll go out, and then we'll go in. I'm gonna leave that hard container for right now. Shouldn't need it, in theory. Oh god. No, you stop it. Stop that. See, that's what I'm saying. Even the down aerial right there wasn't enough to stop them doing their laser attack. It didn't have to kill, it just had to stop them doing it, and it wasn't even strong enough to do that, so... yeah, Sheik's more about fast weak hits, as opposed to slow, strong hits. But then there's Bouncing Fish, so... you know, it's Bouncing Fish is good. I like Bouncing Fish. Ah! Freaking laser beam scares the crap out of me. Get out of here! Alright, one down aerial, and then two... up tilts, I think, is what it took to take that out. I'm also really scared because I just fast fell into the stomach acid. And that just makes me nervous. Because why did I do that, for one thing? But two, we're on higher damage now. And being on higher damage in this area is a scary thing. Can I just... oh my god, I can just do it with the needles. don't even have to jump. We can just take this thing down with needles. Let's do it. Oh, okay. We know a thing. We know a thing that we can do. All right, we're gonna definitely, most definitely, grab this heart container for the second phase of Master Fortress. Let's go. Okay, 10% damage already. Make that way more. 13. It's not really way more, but it's still more in general. Okay, here we go. You get out of my way. You also. How are you shooting me through there? We reached the end of that dude's laser right there. I hit you with some needles. Hit you with some aerials. And maybe another one. There we go. We don't need to waste all that time doing needles. I'll charge them up right now so we've got them, though. Alright, let's go. No, don't wall jump. See, that's a little bit awkward, because you wall jump if you're pushing into the wall or away from the wall. Okay. Nervous. Nerves are kicking in. I gotta play it cool. And by that, I mean I've just gotta actually do better. I don't need to play it cool, I just need to actually be cool. Okay, here we go. Just avoid you. Get the laser first, he's more important to get rid of. There we go. You backed into that for some reason, okay. No, 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 no. Oh, Sheik. You needed to be doing- there. You need to be doing more damage right now, Sheik. Like, right now. Right now! Oh god. Oh god, don't launch me. Okay. Get rid of that thing. Okay. Scared. Real scared. Okay. At least we learned in a previous run, you can just kill all of the enemies in this room. And then they won't come back. As far as we know, anyway. Needles. Yeah, because if we- yeah, there we go. They're gonna come back. Oh, they appear after you, do a certain amount of damage. Luckily, that little flower dude is facing the top. Okay, you're down. Is that it? I think that might be all the enemies. But I'm scared because one touch of the stomach acid stuff and we're dead. Come on, forward smash. Oh my god, we did it. Okay. Ooh, Sheik. Sheiky, sheiky, sheiky. Could that timer stop? That'd be great. 120.91. Okay, Sheik, let's knock your taunts out real quick. We have the up taunt. The side taunt. And the down taunt. Yeah, Sheik doesn't really talk too much, so... Real quick, we gotta do a lot of smash attacks on this thing because it's Sheik. Sheik is not the strongest thing in the world. So it's gonna take a little bit of time to take down Master Core right here. With nothing but smash attacks. I'm actually a little nervous that it's gonna explode. So please don't do that, Master Core. That'd be great. Thank you for not exploding. I appreciate that. Okie dokie. Another run done, another Master Core successfully destroyed, another Master Fortress successfully destroyed. If anyone's keeping track of how many times we've actually beaten Master Fortress, please feel free to post that in the comments, because I for one am going to forget because of how many of these runs I'm doing. And you know, I'm not watching them back or anything like that, I'm just editing them and I'm gonna forget, basically. It's not something that I'm going to remember, so if anyone wants to, like, every time we beat Master Fortress, post a list, or, like, update a list, I guess, of all the characters we've beaten Master Fortress with, post that in the comments, I would be down for that. Because I know, I'm sorry, I forget exactly who it was, but I know someone's been posting, like, all the characters that we've been defeating in the episodes, and that's kind of neat. So if anyone wants to do a similar thing with the characters that we've actually beaten Master Fortress with, and if you want to put the difficulty too, then feel free, then I would not be opposed to that. That's something I'd find pretty interesting to keep track of. I like stuff like that. I like keeping track of different little things like that. It's not exactly a necessary thing to do, but it's a neat little thing all the same. Also, spoiler alert for Zelda Ocarina of Time. If you didn't know, Sheik is just Zelda in disguise. That's what this image is referencing, so... If you somehow didn't know that, congratulations, now you do. Sheik is Zelda. in the older Smash games, you could just use their down B and they would change into each other. You could switch between them whenever you wanted. They're now their own characters, and I'm glad they are if... Well, I mean, they kind of made Zelda just kind of suck because she's by herself now. Sheik was kind of her saving grace, but I don't know. I like that they became their own characters. They are technically the same person, but they became their own characters, which I think is kind of neat. Also, since I mentioned it in a previous episode, we have to get all of these as Sheik, because I would feel real bad if we didn't. Okie dokie. And unfortunately, we didn't get a chance to look at Sheik's final smash during that run, so to training mode we go to take a look at that. If you watched the previous episode, then you'll know Sheik has basically the exact same final smash as Zelda. It's just named the name of the final smash and then Sheik, as opposed to the name of the final smash and then Zelda. This is... Okay, Sheik's so weak she couldn't even break that. This is Light Arrow... Sheik. Yep. Simple as that. Wait, that actually killed Mega Man. Okay. Yeah, I was gonna say Sheik... Sheik's attacks are so weak that she couldn't even break the already weakened training mode version of the Smash Ball with one hit. That's a little depressing. Did I just... You can bouncing fish to get back on stage. I didn't know that. Okay. Update, folks. You can bouncing fish. You just gotta push down and immediately press B, and then you... Okay. Didn't work that time. Hey, Mega Man. That's for you, friend. I think maybe that does more the closer you are, but I could be wrong on that. In fact, I'm almost certain I'm wrong on that. I think it does a fixed damage. And it's... Because it covers, like, the entire screen and just doesn't miss from the second you press the button, I guess, so... Anyway, let's go ahead and take a look at the Sheik Classic Mode Trophy. Which, again, oh god. Please select that first, which again shouldn't be too far down. It's right here. Interesting little tidbit. In Ultimate, all of the characters are... Oh, they were given numbers based on the order that they were revealed. And technically, Sheik was revealed before Zelda in the Melee opening. So Sheik is character number, I think it's 15 or something like that, and then Sheik is whatever number is after Sheik. Zelda is whatever number is after Sheik's. Sheik was technically added to Smash Bros. Before Zelda, according to Smash Bros. Ultimate's official numbering system. And that just annoys me for some reason. In The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, Sheik claimed to be a surviving Sheikah. However, this was just a cunning disguise used by, spoiler alert, Princess Zelda, so she could hide from Ganondorf. In Smash Bros, she's the complete opposite of Zelda, striking with fast attacks that can unbalance her foes. And the two games she has appeared in is Ocarina of Time and Ocarina of Time 3D. She's of course got a Twilight Princess design in this game, but she does not appear in Twilight Princess. As you can tell right here, she looks a little out of place compared to the rest. But Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask, and there's Tingle and Skull Kid. Please be playable. Please be a playable fighter in Ultimate Skull Kid. That would be great. Anyways, with that, folks, that is going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Super Smash Bros. For Wii U. Next time, we'll be taking on Classic Mode as Ganondorf. And if you haven't gathered, yes, we'll be trying it on 9.0. And I will probably sound even more sick than I do right now, but with any luck, I won't. But we will see. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like. And of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.